all the work we've done this week has been with an undamped, zero damping spring system. And what we notice is that when we use an F external with the same frequency as the natural or the unforced oscillations, then we get some kind of resonance behavior. Or if you like, increasing amplitude of the oscillations. And that just happens because we get the one function, which is pushing and pulling, on the mass, which naturally wants to oscillate at that speed, and so you get positive feedback there. Now what happens if we do almost the same frequency for our F external? Well, there, we still expect to get large amplitudes, but not unbounded amplitudes. So when everything was perfectly lined up and we got an exact match, then we'd expect the frequency to get bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and so on. When we use something that's close to the same frequency, well, you're going to get some buildup, but then things might settle down again. And then things might build up again, and then they might settle down again. And if you remember back when we saw that earlier in the course, we called that phenomenon beats because we had sort of an outer wave of the amplitude holding the inner wave of the axial oscillations. But for our purposes and for most mechanical systems, the key thing is that this amplitude is very, very large, or can be very large if you're almost the same frequency, and so something's going to break earlier rather than having to worry about having exact resonance. When we had a frequency that was very different from the F external, we had generally small oscillations. You just didn't get any natural buildup. Again, small here is a matter of proportion to the mass and to the external force's magnitude, but compared to the same magnitude of force with the right frequencies, this kind of forcing with a very, very different frequency doesn't do much to the system. It just doesn't really respond that strongly to it. Next, what if we consider an underdamped system? So small or low damping. Before, it was zero. Now, if we have low damping, and we have a periodic external function with the same frequency, what we get is effective resonance or practical resonance. And what does that mean? Well, if you think about the oscillations that resonance gives, they get bigger and bigger, but if there's damping, the damping puts a natural limit because we can only go so fast. The damper will slow down or resist these super fast motions out here. And so what happens is you tend to stabilize at a large oscillations. So we end up with a steady state behavior. Those are oscillations, and those have a large amplitude. When we have almost the same frequency, it's going to be similar. Because again, the response of the system to the natural frequency is high. And in fact, you don't usually get the dying out thing that you got with the undamped system. You get the same kind of behavior as this. And similar to the undamped case, if you apply an external force at a very different frequency, we don't expect much, or in particular, we expect more specifically a small amplitude oscillation to happen. There will be a steady state happening, but it'll be at a very small amplitude.